this is Stampy, and welcome to a Minecraft Let's Play video, and another video inside of Stampy's lovely world. Today in this video, I am going to be joined by Liebe. This is like one of the thumbnails from my videos, actually, seeing you both standing here like this. You notice my thumbnails, I always like having a big picture of Liebe and then an animal staring right at the screen as well. Anyway, good morning, Liebe, good morning, Esther. I am going to be joined by, of course, Lee and Esther, but I'm also being joined by Squishy. Good morning, Squishy. You can come in. It's okay. You can come and join us. Let's all go and go out on the balcony. Let's all go and have a little dance on the cake together. If we all stand on one corner each, there might be room for all of us. Everyone's got a nudge on Kevin. Oh, no. Esther's not happy. Come on. You can join us again, Esther. There we go. We're all dancing on the cake together. Yay! See? It's important to share your cake, Esther. It's important to share. And oh, no. Lee Bear fell off. We've already had one casualty. The dangerous sport of cake dancing. Oh, dear. Anyway, Lee Bear, the problem is, you see, I'm up here and I'm hungry. And you're down there, and you have my breakfast. So we need some type of a solution. So I'll come to you, Liebe. Let me try and think of how I can do this safely if I land down in this little puddle. There we go. And now I can go and have my breakfast. You like to make me work for it, don't you, Lee? You're not going to try and put me on another diet. You're not going to make me have to run to eat my cake. Nom, 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 nom. Ah, absolutely delicious. And let's have a piece of bread for dessert, just to wash it all down. Anyway, this is a good place to be, because we were about to head straight over to the Love Garden anyway. And that is because today I am adding Matthew. And that's because he sent me this picture of his art contest, which he won. You can see he's got first place on it there, and it's got me, it's got Lee, and it's got two cakes as well. And I'm not entirely sure what it's made out of, but it looks really cool and shiny, and I'm really proud that he was able to win with it. So I wanted to say thank you very much, Matthew, for sending me the picture, and welcome to my love garden. Right then, Liebe, I've already had a little bit of exercise running to the cake, and now it's time for a little bit more exercise running to the doghouse. So let's go and stand behind the love heart. This is our temporary starting line. And what should we do? What could be the challenge for how we're going to do this race this time? So let's just do the utmost fastest route we can run to it. So just all about speed, no matter what way you want to get there. As long as you get there first, you will be the winners. That's what the race is going to be. So let's start in 3, 2, 1, go, 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 go. I can see Lee Bear has already got his ender pearls out. I guess that's the technique he's going for. I'm just going to go and try and dart straight to it and get there as fast as I can. Well, I see he ender pearled. I think he might have actually ender pearled a little bit too far, and he did, and I was able to get in first. Well, actually, I guess Squishy was technically the winner because she was here the entire time. Oh, dear. Well, she did leave before us, so I am going to decide which dog I'm going to take with me. And I'm going to have... let's have Sherbet joining me. Let's have Sherbet. Sherbet, where are you? Where are you hiding? Come on, where's Sherbet? Here's Sherbet. Sherbet's there hiding underneath the little ramp there. You can come and join us. And your job has kind of been a bit of a sheepdog today, I guess, because that is because we are playing our sheep mini game. We are playing Sheep Shuffle, and this is the game that I built entirely in the last episode. We built the entire thing in just one video, which I was very proud about, and it's based on my Sheep Scramble minigame, which I built a long time ago. And the idea of the game is that there's a whole load of sheep, and they're all dyed different colours. Well, there's two of each colour, and then they are all going to get sheared, so you can't see what colour they are, and you then need to try and remember which colour was which sheep. And you need to go and put them into the right pens, and then once they grow back their wool, you can see just how many sheep are in the right place, and you get 1 point for every sheep which is in the right pen. So it's a very simple game, but really good fun. And this is going to be the first time playing it properly with the new rules and being able to use the ropes which we have been using. So let's go and head over there straight away. And the way we're going to do this is we're all just going to take turns having a go, and whoever gets the most sheep in is going to be able to pick another game in my Funland for us to play afterwards. So we are going to be playing two different mini games here. There is also a time limit. There's a time limit of 4 minutes. So you have 4 minutes to try and sort all of the sheep, which is actually probably quite a lot more time than you need, because it's a lot easier using the leads than it was using the wheat in the old game. So if you do finish before then it does not matter. So Sherbet, you can sit down here and you can keep an eye on the scoreboards here. And oh yeah, I did this as well. I added a pretty pattern. I thought that the area around here was a little bit dull with just the grass. So I've not really changed the game, but I added this this pattern around the outside just to basically make it look a little bit cooler. So I did add that in as well. And I don't know, I think it looks quite good, don't you think? I mean, this looks pretty cool. So yeah, I added that in as well. But anyway, we shouldn't waste any time. Let's go straight into the game. And who's going to go first? So first up is going to be Lee Bear. So Lee, if you go and grab some leads, there's also some wheat in here. You can grab some wheat as well if you want. And then that way, you can use that to try and move them around as well. It will be a little bit harder using the wheat than the leads, but you can do whatever you want. And I need to go and get the game set up. So I did tie all the sheep down. That was just to make sure they didn't go wandering off anywhere. So let's go and break away all of these ropes, and then we can go and try and move them all into the middle. And then once we've got them all into the center, I can go and shear them. And then Lee Bear is going to be the person that has to go and try and sort them all out into their right pens. Let's just go and punch away that and that side there, and let's go and do these yellow ones down here as well. And then I'm hoping if I just kind of stand in the middle and hold the wheat, they're all just going to run straight to me and go to the middle. They don't all need to be exactly in the middle, but just so long as they're not in the right pens, then we're going to be okay to go. So let's just try and get this last one's attention. Nope, luckily I do have a lead, so I can just go and pull it in. Right, they all seem to be pretty nicely shuffled up now. Let's just go and bring this one a little bit further into the middle as well. And let's go and get these leads off them, because otherwise I'm going to be taking them with me when I go to leave. So Lee Bear, you've got to watch carefully now, because I'm about to begin the shearing. So I'm going to go snip, 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 and go and shear them all away. And then Lee Bear needs to try and sort them all into their right pen. So your time has started now, Lee Bear. You can begin trying to sort out all of the sheep and getting them into the right pen. It looks like he's immediately grabbed one and knows where he wants to put it. It's always quite easy at first, because the very start of the game, you can just see, like the last one I sheared, you already know exactly what it is. But it's very difficult because you lose track later on. So right now he's going to look back, and because while he's not watching the sheep, they're all wandering around, it's kind of harder to keep track on which ones are supposed to go to what area. So I think the trick to doing well is to not take your eyes off the sheep. Even when you're moving around one of them, you need to go and look back on the rest of the sheep and make sure that you're not losing track of where they are. I think it's definitely a lot easier, and now we're using the leads though. I kind of enjoyed the old version because it was a little bit crazier, but the game was much more about struggling to move the sheep around rather than actually remembering which sheep was what colour. So I think this way it's much more about how well you can remember and how good you are at keeping track of all of the sheep, rather than how good you are at actually trying to move the sheep, because sometimes the sheep aren't very good at obeying you. Sometimes you'll hold wheat, and then the entire flock is just going to follow you and do exactly what you want. And sometimes they all just totally ignore you. And oh, look, looks like one of them has grown its wool back already. And that one is definitely in the right place. I think Lee Bear's just saying thank you to it, therefore, for going into the right pen. So once Lee Bear's put this one down on this fence here, I think that is all of them in their positions. Are you finished now, Lee Bear? Are you happy with where you've put all the sheep? Right then, all we need to do now is wait for them all to grow back their wool, and we can see exactly how well he did. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go and climb up to the top of my desert drop game, because I think from up here I'm going to be able to look down over all of the sheep, and I can hopefully see when they start growing back all of their wool. So I'm going to now speed up the video until all of the sheep have their wool back, and we can see how well Lee Bear did at the game. Okay, so pretty much all of the sheep have had their wool grown back. And you can see how long it took. It's actually become night. That's how long I've been waiting up here. That's one of the problems of this game, is that there's lots of waiting around. But I actually enjoy it, because it's quite intense. Because even though they've finished doing what they need to do, you still don't know who's going to win yet, and how many points they're going to get. So yeah, let's all go to bed quick now. And in the morning, we can go and count up the sheep and see how well Lee Bear did. He's had the difficult job of going first, and so he's going to be setting the score for me and Squishy to try and beat. So let's go and jump our way up the top and see how many he got. So he got one there, the blue one. One, two. We don't know yet. Oh, no, that one's not a yellow one. So that one's in the wrong place. And you can see that there's two of each color. And because that one, so that one's got to be a red one, that one that's not grown its wool back. So yeah, he's got 1 point there, then two, then three, and then four. So he got exactly one sheep right in each pen. So that's half of them in the right place, which is a pretty good score, Lee Bear. Half of them right, certainly not bad at all. So let's go and write down the score over here. I'm just going to go and put a sign on top of his name just so we can keep track of how well he did. And then it's going to be Swayshi's go to try and do even better, which is not going to be an easy task by any means. So let's go and put away this sign here. And let's go and try and move all of the sheep back into the middle. And then Swayshi can go and try and have her go. So let's just go and break away all of the leads. And then I'm going to do the same as I did in the last go. I'm just going to go and hold some wheat and hopefully bring them all into the middle. And jolly good timing, sheep, growing back your wool now. This will make it easier for Squishy. So let's go and break away this lead and this lead down here. Squishy, do you have plenty of leads on you so you can go and tie up all of the sheep? She does. Jolly good. Right, so I'm just going to go and hold the wheat now, and then that will go and bring all of the sheep kind of roughly in the middle, and hopefully just jumble them all up a little bit. Like, it doesn't matter that if they're all exactly in the middle, as long as all of the sheep aren't in the right pens, then it will be yeah, it'll be a fair go for everyone. So there we go. I think I've jumbled up the sheep quite nicely. Squishy, are you watching carefully and ready for me to begin shearing? Right, let's do it then. So I need to go snip, 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 snip. Go and cut off all of the wool. And then once all of the wool's been cut off, I'm going to go and start the 4 minute timer, which I'm pretty sure Squishy won't need because that is a long time. And okay, Squishy, you can begin trying to sort out the sheep. It seems like we do have some cake in the middle of the arena now, and a lot of the sheep are doing what we did this morning and are having good fun jumping up and down on them. But sorry, sheep, I am quite hungry, so yum, I am gonna have to eat a little bit of it. Anyway, I suppose I should be watching what Squishy's doing, because she is the person playing the game right now. Looks like she's put one into her favorite colored pen, the yellow one. You can see she's obviously wearing all yellow here, so it's kind of makes sense that she would remember that. And she's tied two sheep down to one pen. That's fine, there's nothing against that. And oh, she's got lucky there. One of the sheep have grown its wool back already, and that's totally fine. It just makes it a lot easier to know which pen they need to go into. So that means she is 100% definitely got at least 1 point, which is definitely better than nothing. She seems to be moving them at two. You can actually move more than one sheep at a time, and it seems like Squishy decided to do them all in pairs. And so that was a super duper fast round for Squishy. So are you finished? Are you happy with your sheep selection? Right then, brilliant. So what we need to do now is I'm going to go and climb back on top of my desert drop game, and we're going to go and see just how well Squishy did. So the score to beat is 4 points. So hopefully she's got at least four, if not more, in the right pen. And oh, I can see that one has grown back already, and that is the green one, and that one is in the right position. So far, Squishy has got 100% of them right, but let's see if that is going to continue as the rest of them begin to grow back their wool. So once again, I'm going to speed up the video until all of the sheep have their wool back, and we can see just how well Squishy actually did. Right, almost all of the sheep have had their wool fully grown back. That took even longer than the last time. As you can see, the sun is going down yet again, which means we can go to bed. And then in the morning, we're going to count up the score and see how well Squishy did. It also seems that my Minecraft helper's got a little bit bored waiting, and I've decided to build something. So what I think would actually be a good idea for when playing this game, while you're waiting for the sheep's wool to grow back, is to have what I have and loads of other minigames really nearby. So you could play this game and have all of the sheep growing back their wool. And while the wool's growing back, you could go and play a different game and then come back in a few minutes and see how well you did. So you can kind of sort of play this game while in between playing other games. And sure, but I'm sorry for making you sit down the entire time. You can stand up. You can join me. Right then, let's go and see just how well Squashy did. I think she has done really well. So she's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 points right. So this one is going to be a... That's going to be a green one because there's only one green one there. So let me just double check the score. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 points correct. So that's 6 out of 8, Squashy. So that is a really, really good score and going to be very difficult to beat. But I am going to go and certainly try my best. Let's go and make it official. Put down this score, 6 out of 8. And so that means that Lee Bear got 4 and then I got 6, which means if we're doing the 2x table, I should get 8 next. That is probably not going to happen, but I'm certainly going to try my best. But before we start, I want to see what has everyone been building? What is this, Lee Bear? What is this contraption? Oh, I think it's a like a viewing area. Yeah, so instead of having to go up on the desert drop game, I can stand here and I can go and look over most of the sheep. And it's also... I got some tasty cake up here as well. And let's go and quickly see what Squashy built over here. Looks like she's still building it. It's a little house. It's a little home for Squashy. A little hut that you can hide in. Oh, or lock me in while we're playing the game. Right then, it is going to be my go next. Well, tell you what we do while the score has been counted up for me while we are waiting for the sheep. How about you two work together to build a podium for the winner to stand on once we get to the end of the game. So while we're waiting for the sheep to grow back their wool, that's what my two Minecraft helpers can be going and doing. But yeah, it's not time for that yet. Good timing once again, the sheep growing back its wool, because it's going to be my go now. So let's go and break away all of the leads. And this time Lee Bear, I think, and Squashy are going to work together to go and bring all the sheep into the middle. And when I say they can start shearing them, and I need to try and get them all into the right pen. So I need to get at least 6 to be able to draw with Squashy, but hopefully 7 or 8, and then I will be able to be the winner. So what I need to do is try and keep track of as many of the sheep as I can. So once you're ready, bring them all into the middle and then stop holding the wheat so they stop wandering around, and then you can go and begin shearing away and going and getting rid of all of the wool. So there was a yellow one there and a yellow one there, and those were blue ones. Okay, I've already lost track, but they've all lost their wool, so I've started the timer, and let's begin. So I think that these ones were yellow ones, so let's put them two down there. And I think this was a blue one, and then one of these ones was a blue one, maybe. So let's go and bring these two down here. And I think this one was a green one down here. I think this one was already in the right pen. And these ones, I have no idea about. How am I going to be able to work out which ones go where? Let's just kind of see where they want to go. This one, I reckon, is a red one because this one charged straight for the red pen. And do you think that one's a red one as well? I think sure, but my sheepdog was saying that this one is also a red one. And so that means that you must be a green one, I reckon, then. Are you a green one? If you're a green one, then please nod your head. Ooh, I don't... Oh, it didn't... Oh, there we go. There we go. That kind of nodded its head. It looked at me, at least. It looked at me. So let's go and put this one down here. So I got this one definitely right, because this one has grown back its wool already. So that one's definitely a green one. And look, that one is definitely a blue one. So it certainly looks like a good start for me. And that one is red as well. I think I actually did quite well here. So it looks like Lee Bear and Squashy are hard at work building the podium. That looks a little bit like a flower, doesn't it? Here's a little bit more spare wool if you want to try and build it nice and big and fancy. And then I think I am going to go and stand on top of Lee Bear's little podium that he built, and then I can watch the sheep and hopefully see that I have done quite well. It looks like I had quite a good start. Look, I've got at least 4 points. Look, all of the ones that are in their pens are correct so far, so I've at least been able to draw with Lee. So I'm certainly not going to be the loser, but let's find out now if I can be the winner, because I'm going to go and speed up time yet again. Thank you. Right, well, that took nowhere near as long as the other goes. Once again, there is only one sheep that doesn't have its wool back, and that sheep must be not a blue one. Actually, it must be a green one, because there's only one green one, so that means that must be a green one as well, which is good, because it's inside the green pen, and I think this is actually going to be a really close game. And what is this? Is this the podium? Is this the podium the winner's going to stand on? I assume it would be, you know, just a few little blocks, you know, a little bit of a raised platform, but no, it looks like we're going all out. Right, let's go and find out who is going to be the lucky person to stand on top of the podium then. So let's go and count up my score. So I got one there for the blue one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, which means I drew with Squashy. It was a two-way tie. So I'm going to go and put down the score just to make it official, and then we can go and see just how well everyone did. And it looks like it's going to be me and Squashy sharing the kind of huge, crazy-looking podium. So there we go. Here's the final score. It was 4-6-6. So right, how do we get on this podium? I guess you can be halfway up the podium lead there. You can stand on that little perch there, and I'm going to go and head all the way to the top. It's like a parkour puzzle to try and get up here. I've got to climb up all of these ladders, and then can I get up here? Yep, there we go. Squashy, do you want to come and join me on the top? Well, I guess if you stand on that cake on one side, I'll stand on the cake on the other side, and Lee Bear, slip down there. Lee Bear's going to stay about halfway up. So here we go. Here's the winner's podium. One of the more unique winner's podiums I've ever seen. And that was Sheep Shuffle. That was a really good, fun game. I really enjoy playing that game. But because me and Squashy won, it means we can decide together which minigame we want to play. So shall we go for a little bit of a wander then, and just see which minigames take our fancy. So let's just go and have a little bit of a walkabout. I'll tell you what, Squashy, you can just walk to whatever game you want to play, and I'll let you know whether I want to play it as well, and then that will be a good way to decide. So why don't you lead the way and go to whichever game you fancy playing, and then, if you just look at me, and I'll tell you whether I fancy playing it as well. So it just needs to be a game that three of us can play, which is a bit weird because most of my games are designed for either two or possibly four. I don't know how many three-player games I have. It looks like Squashy's heading off in this direction. We got the water game there. We got Gold Grab. We got the Honey Hunt game is over in this direction. Nope, she doesn't fancy playing any of those. We got the Burning Bridge game. That doesn't really work with three players. Either does the Switch game. There is this game. There's the Take the Tooth game. That would work. We also have the Whale of a Time game. That would work with three of us. We could kind of do a 2v1 on a Sharky Shark. There's also Doggy Hockey. It looks like Squashy wants to play Whale of a Time. Okay, let's do it then. Let's have a game of a Whale of a Time. So as soon as you picked it, Squashy, you can go first. So what you need to do is you can press this button here, and out will come a piece of coloured wool, which is red in this case, and she now needs to go and fire up into the air and try and land inside of one of the red hoops. So let's go and grab some TNT here and put it into this TNT cannon. I just need to put it in a circle around here like this, and then put some on the top here like this, and then all Squashy needs to do is she'll go into the water and press the button, and if all goes well, she's going to be fired out the blowhole of the well and land into one of the hoops, and hopefully for her sake it's going to be landing inside one of the red ones. So there she goes. Oh, not the biggest of launches. Oh, she nearly landed in it anyway. There we go. Okay, I'm going to give you half a point for that, Squashy, for effort. Right then, so Squashy got half a point for her go. Lee Bear, it's your go next. You want to go and press the button. Oh no. Oh, dearie me. Lee Bear needs to land in the black hoop. And the black hoop is the hardest one to land in. It's the one which is furthest away. And so it's very difficult to get far enough to be able to land in it. So hopefully Lee Bear can go a little bit further than Squashy did. Oh, I can hear the TNT hissing already. He's about to be launched. And did he go? Did you see him? Did you see a bear flying through the sky? I'm not sure whether he got launched. Nope! That was another failed launch here. Let's go and put the TNT back in, Lee Bear. And as soon as you didn't even leave the well, we'll let you have another go. You need to make sure you line up exactly with the hole on the ceiling to make sure you get fired out properly. So, Lee Bear, do you want to go back in and press the button? You can have another go and make sure you go far enough to try and land inside of the black hoop. So let's go and watch the well. And oh, nope. I think they keep hitting the little fin on the top of the well. I think you might be holding forward a little bit too much. I'll tell you what, Lee Bear, let's have you and Squishy both trying to launch at the same time. But this is for both of you going to be your last attempt. So if you don't go now, then sadly you won't get any more attempts. So you need to make sure you make this one count. So if you just go in the water and keep holding A, you'll keep bouncing up and down. And hopefully you'll go far enough to land in the black hoop. That is what both of you are going to have to be aiming for. So it's all come down to this. And there we go! They have both launched together. Looks like Squishy went a lot higher than Lee Bear. Where's Lee Bear going to land? Oh, I think Lee Bear did it. Lee Bear managed to land in the black hoop. Squishy hit one of the hoops, but wasn't able to go through it. But don't worry, she would have respawned just over there and can come and join us again. Right, it's going to be my go now. Let's press the button. I need to do the lime green one. I'm actually running out of TNT here. I'm going to grab a little bit more, and let's see if I'm going to be able to land inside of the lime green hoop. So let's go and place this TNT like this, and let's go and press the button. And I need to go forward, make sure I'm in line with the blowhole. That seems to be all good and dandy, and up we go. Right, I just need to pick one of the hoops. Let's go for this one on the far left one over here, right, just underneath that yellow one, and perfect, right in the very middle of the hoop. Jolly good. So there we go. That is about the end of this episode here. Hopefully you enjoyed seeing us playing all of these jolly good fun mini games. And the next episode, I'm going to be going and heading back to my house to build something new over there. Make sure you check out the next episode to see exactly what that's going to be. But for now, in my lovely world, I want to thank you all very much for watching, and I will see you all later. Bye.